Right now we're going to what I call a pan roast. It's a loin of lamb. It's small enough where you can get away with doing this entirely on the top of the stove. It'll take a while, but it's really neat because when you have, again, good equipment, you can actually control the heat and cook this very, very slowly, so you'll have a nice medium rare lamb, and you'll have it beautifully browned on the outside. Again, the oil goes in, and you can see it starts to shimmer a little bit. It's not smoking. And this is what's really important. You don't want to put your oil in the pan and have it start to smoke. At that point, it's too burnt. The oil burns and everything tastes burnt. We're going to season it. Good amount of salt. Now, that's a little bit of fat on this lamb. I think that's fine. And you go in the pan. Now, you notice right away, it's already starting to cook, but it's gentle. But I really want to show that by controlling the heat, and actually using lower temperature, you can cook this right on top of the stove, and actually it's a beautiful effect. But again, I'm listening. It starts to cook a little too high. I'm going to lower the flame. One thing that I find that a lot of home cooks or young cooks don't do is they're not really looking at what's happening in this pan. And this is telling you everything you need to know. This is going to take a good 10 to 12 minutes on top of the stove. People have a tendency right now to turn this up because they want to cook it faster and get it over with. But what happens is, when you're pushing all that meat to the center, right, the reason you want something to rest is the juices then go back out into the meat. You ever notice sometimes when you get a piece of meat, like a lamb loin, and it's cooked, and there's a bullseye in the center, the rest of it's kind of gray around the outside? That's because it was over-seared. I want to go for a really, really slow. You see the meat, that side starting to sear a little bit. But it's not burning. You're not getting, if this pan were too hot, one thing you'd see right now, you'd see black edges, or really, really dark edges. When you have a high quality pan, like this made in a saute pan here, it holds the heat so you can actually do low temperature cooking. If this were something that were flimsy or not high quality, you wouldn't be able to hold the heat in the pan. And so this wouldn't cook at all. So if you look at that again, it's still starting to turn golden brown. It's starting to cook through on the sides over here. When I cook meat, if I'm cooking a steak or something, I usually turn it 4 times. And the good thing about this right now is we're in complete control of this. We're controlling heat, we're cooking our food, and we're not panicking because this is going to start to sear and flame up and overcook. See, now it's really starting to brown up. Browning doesn't really come from high heat and searing. It comes from that Maillard reaction of the sugars coming out. And what we're finding here is an accumulation of the fat that's rendering from the lamb. You notice, remember when we started, we only had a tiny bit of oil in there, and now we have all this lamb fat that's cooking in. Okay? But again, nice and gentle. And you notice one thing I'm not doing, I'm not shaking this back and forth. You don't need to do that. And the other thing to see is all this fat that's here that we're going to use to baste this lamb, it's not burning. It's not smoking. And like I said, we're going to go a couple times on the side. So we're going to go back to the fat side. Cook that a little more. I can feel it now. It's still quite rare in the center, but it's starting to firm up. I always like to say, if you look in a pan and something looks good, there's a good chance it is good, but that's starting to look really tasty. See how nicely browned it is. Beautiful golden brown. It's not black, it's not dark on edges, it's kind of uniformly cooked. And that's what you're looking for. You see a piece of meat like that, someone's actually knows what they're doing, they're in complete control of their cooking. A piece of meat this size, you want to let that rest for probably a good 4 or 5 minutes before we cut into it.